We are learning journal entry sums. In that, today I am going to teach you sum number 8. Past journal entries in the books of Sasi Kumar, who is dealing in automobiles. Sasi Kumar is the name of the proprietor and he is dealing automobiles business. 2017 October month transactions have given. First, put the question number, then write the title, journal entries in the books of Sasi Kumar. Then you are going to do the sum in a single page. Take a page, look at this column, allot the columns like this. First column, date, then particular, then one small column for LF. LF means ledger folio number. Then two amounts column, one is for debit and another one is for credit. Then come to first transaction. October 1, 2017, commenced business with goods ₹40,000. Sasi Kumar started business with goods on 1st October 2017. Under date column, write the date. 2017 is common for all, so write 2017 at the top. Then October 1 is the date. He commenced business with goods. Goods are otherwise known as stock. You may write, you may use the word stock or goods. So goods comes into the business. Here you are going to apply the real account rule. What is your real account rule? Debit what comes in, credit what goes out. Here stock comes into the business, so stock account must be debited. Sasi Kumar brings the goods as a capital, so here we are going to use personal account rule. According to our personal account, debit the receiver, credit the giver. Here the giver is Sasi Kumar, so write to Sasi Kumar capital account. As I already told you, all of your debited account should carry the word debtor at the end of the row, but no need to write credit for credited account. You should write to Sasi Kumar's capital. Start with the word to Sasi Kumar's capital account. Amount is ₹40,000. Debit amount should be written on the same line, debited account line, and credited account amount should be written on the Sasi Kumar's capital account line. Both debit and credit amounts ought to be equal. This is like a weighing plate, so both plates ought to be equalized. All debit accounts must be equal to all credit accounts. Then write the narration. Start with the word being, or start with the word for. Being business started with goods is the narration. Write the transaction short, in short form. Being business started with goods. Do you understand, children, how we are applying golden rules of double entry system in transaction? October 3, cash introduced in the business ₹60,000. Sasi Kumar brings the capital in the form of cash also. So on October 3, write the date. Cash comes into the business. Here you are going to apply real account rule. Debit what comes in, credit what goes out. So cash comes into the business. Cash account debtor. He brings cash in the name of capital. Here you are going to apply personal account rule. Debit the receiver, credit the giver. Here Sasi Kumar is the giver. So to Sasi Kumar's capital account. Write like this. You should start the word to after leaving some space from the line. Okay. Then write the amount. Amount is rupees 60,000. 60,000 must be written in two amount columns. 60,000 in debit amount column and 60,000 in capital account row. 60,000 in Sasi Kumar capital account line. Do you understand? Then write the narration. Being cash introduced, all the journal entries are to be followed with narration. Don't forget to write the narration. October 4, purchased goods from Arul on credit 70,000. Sasi Kumar purchased goods from Arul without paying cash. For credit, he purchases goods. So, write date. Here, you are going to apply real account rule. When you purchase goods from others, goods will come into the business. Here you are going to apply nominal account rule. When you purchase or when you buy goods from your supplier, goods comes into the business. For that goods we have to pay money. That is expense for us. Here you have to apply nominal account rule. What is your nominal account rule? Debit all expenses and losses, credit all incomes and gains. So purchases account must be debited. For purchases we have to pay cash. So purchases account must be debited. Purchases account debtor. Then who will be the giver? If you pay cash, cash goes out from the business. But here, you are purchasing for credit. So, here you are going to apply personal account rule. Debit the receiver, credit the giver. Here, the giver of the purchase is Mr. Arul. So, write to Arul account. Amount is rupees 70,000. Amount should be write like this. 70,000 in debit column and 70,000 in credit column. Then write the narration. Being goods purchased for credit. Do you understand? October 6, returned goods to Arul rupees 10,000. Out of goods purchased rupees 70,000. Now Sasi Kumar is returning goods to Arul rupees 10,000. Return is known as purchase return. When you return your purchase, goods goes out. Receiver of that return is Mr. Arul, isn't it? When you return the goods to your supplier, the supplier will receive the goods. Here, you are going to apply personal account rule. Write the date, October 6. Arul is the receiver. Arul account must be debited. Account debtor. Then write two purchases. When you return the purchase, goods goes out. So according to our real account rule, credit what goes out. What is our real account rule? Debit what comes in, credit what goes out. Here goods goes out in the name of purchase return. So write two purchase return account. Write the amount 10,000 in both columns, being goods returned to Arul. Do you understand? October 10, paid cash to Arul on account 60,000. Sasi Kumar paid cash to the supplier Arul, rupees 60,000. He purchased goods for 70,000 from Arul, but he returned 10,000 worthy goods to him. Now Sasi Kumar is liable to pay 60,000. He paid the cash on October 10 to Arul, 60,000. Come to your journal entry. Write the date under date column. Arul account must be debited because Arul is the receiver of the cash. When you pay cash to your supplier, Arul is the receiver, isn't it? So according to our personal account, debit the receiver. Arul account must be debited. Then you are paying through your bank. You may take it as the payment is by bank or by cash, whatever you may take. Here I assume it as through bank. So write to bank. Banker is a giver. Your banker is a giver to Arul. So bank account must be credited according to our personal account. Do you understand? Then write the amount 60,000 on both columns, being cash paid to Arul. Do you understand? October 15, sold goods to Chander on credit 30,000. Come to journal entry. Under date column, write the date. When you sell goods to your customer on credit, you have to apply personal account rule. Who is the receiver? Chander is the receiver of the goods. According to our personal account, debit the receiver, credit the giver. Chander is the receiver, so Chander account must be debited. When you sell goods to others, you will receive money for that. That money will be gain or profit for you. You have to credit the sales account according to our nominal account. Debit all expenses and losses, credit all incomes and gains. Here you are receiving the income through sales. So write two sales, 30,000, 30,000 in both columns. Do you understand, children? Then write the narration, being goods sold to Chander on credit. October 18, Chander returned goods worth rupees 6,000. Come to journal entry. Write the date. October 18, Chander, your customer, is returning some goods to Sasi Kumar. That return is called sales return because you have sold to Chandar. When the sales return to the business, that return is called sales return. When sales return happens, goods comes into the business. Here you have to apply real account rule, debit what comes in. Here goods comes in the name sales return. So write sales return account debtor. Then who is the giver? Chandar, your customer is the giver of that return. Here you have to apply personal account rule. Debit the receiver, credit the giver. Chandar is the giver, so Chandar account must be credited. Amount rupees 6,000 in both columns. Write the narration, being goods returned by Chandar. Do you understand? October 20, received cash from Chandar in full settlement rupees 23,000. See children, on October 15, he have sold goods to Chandar for rupees 30,000. On October 18th, Chandar returned goods worth rupees 6,000. So balance amount is rupees 24,000 is to be paid by Chandar. October 20th, Chandar paid rupees 23,000 as a full settlement. Full settlement means hereafter he won't pay money for that particular transaction. He closes his account by giving 23,000 instead of 24,000. What about that 1,000 rupees? The 1,000 rupees is to be taken as discount allowed, though we
haven't allowed.
The customer Chandar has taken the money by his own, so we have to treat that money like discount allowed. Do you understand? Write the date under date column. Here
we receive money.
When you receive money, cash comes into the business. So here you will apply golden rules of double entry system. I mean real account rules. What is real account rule? Debit what comes in, credit what goes out. Here cash comes in, so cash account must be debited. Rupees 23,000 only comes in. Then discount allowed, the 1,000 rupees Chandar fails to pay, rupees 1,000, that amount is discount allowed. Discount allowed is the loss for the business, isn't it? So it should be debited according to our nominal account rule. What is our nominal account rule? Debit all expenses and losses, credit all incomes and gains. Here discount allowed is a loss, so debit the discount allowed account. Discount allowed account debtor 1,000 rupees. Do you understand? Then who is the giver of the cash? Chandar is the giver. So according to our personal account rule, debit the receiver, credit the giver. Here Chandar is the giver, so you have to credit Chandar account, right? To Chandar account 24,000. This 23,000 and 1,000 rupees in debit column combinedly will come to credit column. Okay. Then write the narration, being cash received from Chandar in full settlement. 25, paid salaries through ECS 2000. Sasi Kumar gives salary to his employees through ECS. Write date under date column. Salaries is one of our expense. Here you are going to apply nominal account rule. Debit all expenses and losses. Here name of the expense is salary. So salaries account must be debited. Sasi Kumar pays the salary through ECS. ECS means electronic clearing services. Electronic clearing services is a service provided by the banker to pay our regular payment. Based on our standing instruction. So banker is the giver of that salary. Here you are going to apply personal account rule. Debit the receiver, credit the giver. Banker is a giver, so write to bank account 2000. Bank account must be credited 2000. You understand? Then write the narration being salaries paid through ECS. October 30, Sasi Kumar took for personal use goods worth rupees 10,000. Sasi Kumar is dealing in automobiles business. He took the goods worth rupees 10,000 on 30th October. If the proprietor takes money or goods from his business, that money or goods are treated as drawings, because business is different from the businessman. I mean, drawings is expense or loss for the business. So here you should apply nominal account rule. Debit all expenses and losses. Here the name of the loss is drawings. Otherwise we can take it as expense. If he repay the drawings in one day, it will be treated as expense. If he fails to pay, it will be taken as loss. So in for both the cases should use nominal account rule. So drawings account must be debited. Proprietor takes the goods in the name of drawings for personal use. He takes the goods, so it is called drawings and it should be debited according to nominal account rule. Write like this, then write the amount 10,000. Then he takes from his business, so goods goes out. Here you will apply real account rule. According to our real account, debit what comes in, credit what goes out. Here stock goes out from the business, so write to stock account or write to goods account. Amount is rupees 10,000. Do you understand? Then write the narration being goods taken for personal use. Write like this. Do you understand? So this is your sum number 8. You should apply the golden rules of double entry system in the transaction like this. Hope you will understand. Thank you, children. We'll meet you in next class.